Hi, in this new tutorial we will see how we can subdivide equally editable poly edges by inserting vertices in equal distances. So first here I have a plane with two faces. I will convert it to an editable poly object and I will go to edge sub-object level. I will expand this graphite tool here. I will select this edge. Here I have this spinner. It controls how many vertices I like to insert equally. So I will choose 4 and I will click this arrow. And max switches immediately to vertices, vertex sub-object level. You can see here the newly inserted vertices are selected automatically. So I will go back to edge sub-object level and I will select this one. I can choose more than one edge at a time. Let's see, let's say I want to insert two vertices on both of them. So I will type 2 and click insert vertices, and as you can see here I have two vertices and here I have two, and the edges are equally subdivided. I will undo and I will go back to edge and I will choose this one and subdivide it. I will add two vertices here and I will choose this one and I will choose 4, like the top one. So here I have 4, 2, and 4 here. From now on I can click, for example, this one and this one, and using control I can select multiple vertices. I can click connect. I can click choose these ones and press connect. I can choose this one and connect, this one and this one, choose connect. Remember, the connect only works with vertices that are in the same that share the same polygon. You cannot jump over edges. So, but in my case here, I've chosen 3 vertices at a time. So the connection happens from this one to this one and then from this one to this one. Also I can choose this one and click on this one and connect, this one and this one, connect. I can go further and maybe I like to subdivide this one to 2. I want to add 2 vertices here, so I can add 2 here. I can click on this edge and maybe add only 1 vertex in the middle. So here I can start, you know, making a pattern. Same here. I can subdivide this to 3, for example, and this one 2, and I can start to make it more complex. And you can experiment with these. Now I can choose some polygons randomly. Maybe do some negative extrusion, small extrusion, then another one, bigger one, then another one, maybe a smaller. And then yeah, so also you can, I will choose maybe some of these. Extrude forward positively. go to border and choose all this border, choose, press scale, press R on the keyboard and press shift and drag on the X and Z to extrude and then extrude again. This way when I add a turbo smooth I can have some planner area before I start to go to these holes and the bumps. I can add a turbo smooth now with two or three subdivisions, and I can have something like this. This is the reason why I added small extrusions here, because I like to have some flat areas here and some flat areas here, and I want the smoothness to happen between these polygons here only, because Turbo Smooth ignores faces that have a zero angle between them. Turbo Smooth will add polygons, but nothing will change in their topology, only with polygons that are that have a bigger angle than zero between them. So this is why here you can see that you can here it stays flat and the smoothness happens here and here. Anyway, this is how you do it, and I hope this video was useful. If you like it, please press the like button, subscribe to the channel. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comments area, and see you next time. Thank you.